Welcome back to the program, Psychofans. Okay, today, next project, we're going to tackle the front windshield cowl, the E36 M3. It's all buggered up. It's falling apart, it's dry rotted, it's peeling, it's cracking. We've got to take the old one off, put the new one on. Again, in theory, this should not be that difficult. This should be a DIY home project for you guys if you have any ounce of talent whatsoever. So again, the litmus test is if I can do this, absolutely anybody can do this. Let's just take a quick inventory of what we're working with.
Obviously, you're going to need your new front windshield cowl pieces. Since we're dealing with a sedan here, this comes in two pieces. If you have a coupe or convertible, you're going to get one piece. We've got our fasteners. This is a kit. It comes from ECS Tuning, so you'll get the cowl and the fasteners together. Then we've got a windshield wiper removal tool. If you got a screwdriver, you might be able to just finesse it off. Torque wrench, socket set, maybe screwdriver or something to pry some caps off. But that's pretty much all the tools I think we're going to need. As I mentioned in another video, the whole front windshield cowl is falling apart. I've taken electrical tape here to try to just keep it together. But as you can see here, as I start pulling it off, see how it's coming apart in pieces? It's dry rotted. So we're going to have to pull this all out, and then I'm sure we're going to have to clean it up. I'm sure there's all kinds of dirt underneath there. And so we'll do it kind of just like we did the rear window seal. We'll clean it off as best we can, and then put the new one on. We'll be good to go. So let's get started.
Okay, step number one is to get these wiper blades or these wiper arms off. So just using a small little teeny screwdriver here to sort of pop these caps off. And this might be too wimpy for the job, so let me get a bigger one. It's coming slowly. You'd think it would be even easier than this. Here we go. One off.
Two off. Okay.
Okay, next we're gonna take this off with a 13 millimeter socket. Make sure you don't lose these. We'll put these where the caps are. Now, some wiper blades will come off easy and some won't. What I want to do is I want to mark where these wipers are so I get them lined up properly when I put them back on the car. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little mark right there. Another one kind of right there. You can barely see it. So I know I need to line those up next time when I put these things back on. So let me do the same over here. Now, I happen to have a windshield wiper removal tool, which is really handy. If you don't have this, you might be able to just yank this off, pry underneath it, get it off. But we're going to take the safer approach here. Let me unwind all this. And this thing should pop off easily without breaking the wiper arm. You don't want to do that. And they will break. You got to be careful with them. They're not as durable as you think they are. And I'm probably going to have to take this off first. So let me do that. Okay, we're gonna take this piece
And this should clip right off. That side's off. There we go, that's the rubber piece that's off. There we go, just clips into place, you just unclip it. Put this back in, underneath. Just holds it into place. And we did it without breaking the arm. So one off. There we go. And number two off. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start pulling this off. You wanna start driver's side first, okay? And it should just pull off. It's in there with some fasteners and stuff. Actually, before I do that, let me pull the electrical tape off that I was using to sort of keep this thing even remotely together. Here we go. That is totally coming apart in pieces. Okay, now on the passenger side, we got a couple black fasteners here. We need to remove these. You just need a flathead screwdriver. They kind of just screw off a little bit. It's a couple of these. Set those aside so you don't lose them. And now this thing should, in theory, pop out too. Bingo. And we have it out. Obviously, we have a pigsty here that we're gonna have to clean up. So, before we go any further, let's see if we can get this cleaned up as best we can. So that's about as clean as it's gonna get just with vacuuming. So now we're gonna have to take the cleaners and stuff and tack a little bit more and see how much better we can get it. This could take a while because there's this, there's not an easy way to get this out. Yeah, it's gonna be ugly. And in theory, you're not going to see this because the cowling's going to go back over it, but like I tell you, do it once, do it right. You don't have to worry about it anymore. Okay, I'm going to have to get some more small pry tools to help me out. Just trying to loosen it up as best I can. There is no special talent needed to do this type of stuff. Though it is handy if you've got, you know, pry tools like this, where you can wrap a rag around it and get into some of these tighter areas. Okay, so let me tackle this for a few more minutes and see how much progress I make. Thank you. Okay, I spent a little bit longer on it than I would have liked, probably more like 45 minutes. Looking a lot better than it did. Again, not perfect, but certainly better than what it was.
It's about as good as it's gonna get. So we've cleaned it up really good. Now it's time to put the new cowling on. As you can see,
it's got places here for those grommets and fasteners. And interestingly enough, that was one of the only ones that stayed behind. So I'm wondering if when I yanked the old one out, if some of those fasteners came with it. Yeah, it looks like a few did. You can see them right there. So we're gonna be replacing all of those. So what I've done is I pulled the old sort of rubber grommets out, and as part of the kit, you get replacement ones. So there should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them. So
that's what is in this package here. So we're gonna pop those back in.
Let's pop these in one at a time. They sort of just lay in there. I wouldn't even say they snap in. And one more over there.
Okay, so here's the rubber lip that's going to sit along the edge of the windshield. This is the passenger side, got the driver's side. We're going to put, if you look on the opposite side here, the underside, you got these little slots. And that's where we're going to slide these little fasteners into, and once they lock into place, we'll just pop it right back on those little grommets that are already in the body. Okay, sliding the little fasteners into place. They kind of just lock in. And we're going to do the same for this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. It's amazing when you start tinkering with these cars how so much of this stuff gets put together almost puzzle-like, you know? There's not as many screws and nuts and rivets as you think there are. A lot of stuff is being held together by snaps. Okay. Why are we missing one? Okay, you see that there's, I got a fastener right there in that side, and then there's that hole right there, then another hole right there.
Well, those two holes are gonna fit over those two screws, but there's no fastener connection there, so we don't need a grommet there.
So we're gonna pull him out and put him over here. Not sure why they did it that way, but we'll roll with it. Okay, one last thing to notice here. Because this is a sedan, this cowling's in two pieces, and you can see here in the middle, one side is gonna overlap the other, which means this side needs to be put in place first because it's gonna go underneath. So this is the passenger side first. So let's try to pop him in.
Okay. There. Thank you.
Okay. One in, let's do the other.
So here we got four fasteners, they should all line up. One, two, actually five. Three, four, five.
Up on here. There we go.
Absolutely make sure these things are lined up. I don't want to break a fastener. Where's the first one? There's the first one. Let me get the first one in. There we go. To be a little bit of a gap there, and I don't know why. That fastener, it's not in.
Okay, I gotta motherfuck it a bit. This fastener is not in. Might be able to. You fucking whore. This is why nothing ever goes according to plan. Never does. Well, what happened was the groove that connects this one right here broke off. You fucking asshole. The groove that this slides into broke off. So now it won't stay. You mother. That's a problem. That is a problem. Well, that one's wrong.
you can see here, there's a gap all the way down underneath it. And one of the problems is this grommet broke right here. So that's fucked up. And then this one here, no matter how hard I push in, it won't snap in. It's like the grommet that sits in the body is loose. And even if I snap it in, it's not staying. So we've got a major fucking problem here. I may have to order an entirely new driver side piece and new grommets in order to make this work. Because I already broke one of the tracks underneath that holds that grommet. So that's fucked up. And then this one, it won't even stay. So that's a problem. That is a real fucking problem. There's no way that that is watertight. Passenger side is fine. It's the driver's side that's fucked up. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a grommet right there. And it'll go into the little hole it's supposed to go into, but it just pulls the grommet out with it. That's not good. So, to be continued.
Another windshield cowling. More grommets and fasteners. Now, let's see if we don't foobar this up this time. Because I'm not ordering another one of these. This was a $45 setback and about a 4-day setback. So we are going to attempt to put this in again, and it has to go in right this time. So let's see if we can get this right.
Hey Chris, you took the leather bra off. Yeah, I sure did. It wasn't on there for looks, it was on there to keep the drive home from Florida relatively safe and secure from rock chips. Okay, you know the routine. We gotta put the rat bastard in right in there. Let's see if we can get this right.
Okay, first order of business. We are putting the grommets in. This is pretty straightforward. You would think we couldn't screw this up. There's five of them on the driver's side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, let me get my gloves. Making sure I got these pushed in as far as they can go so they don't come out. That is as far as they're going to go. Okay. Now, let's get the cowling and the fasteners. Okay, putting the fasteners in. And remember, when we put this on the car, we're going to have to adjust each of these slightly to make sure they go into the grommet correctly. Okay, let's take this over to the car. Okay, Chris, whatever you do, don't fuck this up. We can't afford any more delays.
I'm gonna look this way and try to line these bastards up. I got one. So, we got that going for us. I mean, that's not even close. Really not even close. Last time too. Okay, ooh, I got it in. See, this one just doesn't want to snap, and that was the problem with the other one. Let's see if I can get this next one in. Fucking son of a bitch! Let's see if I can get this next one in. Okay, that one might be okay. It doesn't want to snap in, but it's down. The other ones are in. It might be okay. Well, I think we did it. This one right here is not in perfect. It kind of wants to come out just a little bit. It doesn't want to seat into the grommet, but these other ones are now in okay. And I think it's gonna stay. I mean, there's a little bit sticking up just a hair there, but all things considered, it looks pretty good. If you're looking along the edge of the windshield there and the cowling, it's almost completely flush against the windshield now. It's just sticking up a hair, kind of in this neck of the woods here. Just sticking up a little bit right there, but not much. And there's a little bit. There's a little bit right there, but I think that'll lay flat over time once this is out in the sun and stuff. It should take care of itself.
I could have easily just edited this out. You know, I could have bought another left windshield cowling and put it on and showed you guys, and you know, it would have maybe looked like a genius, but that's really not why you're tuning in. You want to see me fuck things up, so. Because of the way I feel for all you, and I'm sure the reason why you watch the channel is so you can see how things really go. And the unedited version is exactly what you're getting here. So,
get them on there first. Let me get the other one.
Come to Papa.
Man, a little bit more frustrating, to be honest, than I thought it was going to be. But that's kind of what happens when you're DIYing. You know, things don't go according to plan sometimes. You got to just roll with it and go to plan B. So when I broke the driver's side windshield cowling with the grommets and fasteners and stuff, just had to order a new part, wait for it. It kind of put me in a holding pattern here with some of these other projects I wanted to do. but that's just kind of the way it is. And, you know, this happens at shops too, okay? I mean, mechanics and stuff, they break apart now and then, putting stuff on, taking stuff off, and, you know, they just got to order a new part and do it. They don't even tell you about it. So, you know, that's just kind of part of the process. That's the method to the madness sometimes, and you just got to do the best you can. So we got around it, okay? We order a new part, we learn from what our mistakes. Okay, when I say our, I mean my mistakes, okay? Learn from my mistakes and put the new piece on, and it went in fine. So really the lesson here is just, you know, learn from what I did wrong. Take your time with it. Make sure those grommets and fasteners, they got a little bit of play with them. The tolerances here on these cars are not absolutely perfect. So you got some wiggle room to make those things go in right. And if you just take your time and you do it right, it should go in right the first time. You don't have to have the same problem that I did. So there you go. This one, check it off the list. It's done. We'll move on to the next project. If you like this video, like it. If you didn't like it, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, this is what the channel is all about. So if this is your first time coming to the channel, hey, subscribe. You know, you never know. You might like it. You might like more of these videos. And if you haven't already, share this on YouTube and all your social media channels, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all that good stuff. Take care.